these feathers.
Hi everybody, Bobby from the Rabbitry Center, and today I wanted to talk about watering your rabbits as well as your chickens in the wintertime. You know, in the wintertime with freezing temperatures, it's really no fun keeping your animals hydrated. It's just really important that you do that. So we'll talk about our system, and if you stick with us to the end, we'll talk about how we get more does out of our litters when we breed our rabbits. Here we go. This morning it was 16 degrees, so I thought it was a great day to film this video. You know, at this point, the spigot has already frozen. We've had to disconnect the hose, wind up the hose. You know, we can't use that anymore. We don't have a laundry tub right out near the back door that's thawed, so we actually have to use our faucet. Our laundry tub's downstairs, and that's just, I'm not taking it up the stairs. So what we did was purchase an aerator that has a higher gallon per minute ratio. I'll put some down in the description below, but you're going to want to match up the aerator to your faucet. So what I used to do was bail the 2-gallon bucket into the 5-gallon bucket, but we recently installed a new faucet and it's got a bigger, taller spout, so I can put the 5-gallon bucket right in the sink. We leave our 5-gallon bucket and 2-gallon bucket right outside our slider door. So every morning we pull the buckets in, we rinse them out, and we're filling up the buckets with lukewarm water. So the 2-gallon bucket we're going to use to dip our 4-cup bowls into, and that gets the ice to pop out immediately. And the 5-gallon bucket we're gonna fill up to fill all the bowls. Now once we're done with this 2-gallon bucket, we will just take that to the chicken coop. That's our chicken water. So once we have our 2-gallon bucket and our 5-gallon bucket full of lukewarm water, we'll take it out to the rabbitry. Now what we need to do is undo our bungee straps. We use 4-cup Rubbermaid bowls. Now these bowls we can get off the internet. You also can find these bowls at Family Dollar or Dollar General. And you want to use 4-cup bowls because that's enough water where it will last 12 hours long. Some litters too will kind of jump up there and push on the bowl, and sometimes we'll have to use 2 bungee straps instead of 1 because we know there's going to be a lot of pressure on that bowl and we don't want the water to dump out. So first we have to pull all the Rubbermaid bowls, dip them in the lukewarm 2-gallon bucket, and pop out the ice. Once we pop all the ice out, we'll refill all the buckets. From time to time, the rabbits are so thirsty and excited to take a good cold drink that they've already pulled their bowl into the cage, and you have to pull it back out, put it back on the strap. What I do is I go right down the line and I fill all the bowls up, and it makes it quick. But I would be careful on trying to pop that ice out without dipping it, because what happens is that Rubbermaid bowl gets so cold and brittle that it will just crack. The whole bowl will crack. Now if you dip it in that water, it'll warm it up and it won't crack. You won't have to worry about that. Now studies have shown that rabbits will drink more from a bowl than they will from those bottles with the nipples. We don't use those because if you don't plug those in, if you're not using the heated bottles, that as soon as you hit freezing temperatures, that little ball bearing at the end of the nipple will freeze. They won't have access to that water. And if your rabbits can't drink, they'll stop eating, and that's no good. So you want to make sure your rabbits stay hydrated in the wintertime. You know, there's a lot of productions out there that use the bottles with the nipples, and there's heat up bottles, and we have those in our storefront if you want to check them out. We also have heat up bowls as well, but since we started our rabbitry and our chickens, we try our best to raise our livestock and keep them comfortable using solar energy, using greenhouse effect, using just good genetics, cold hardy animals. Even our chickens, they're still laying eggs. Like I said, it's 16 degrees right now. It's not so much the light, it's that cold. It's really gonna shut them down. Oats, black oil seeds, a couple slices of bread, some corn, and some pellet or crumbles. Your chickens will continue to lay. They'll have the nutrition needed to keep laying. We'll put the heater that we use down in the description below if you're interested in that. At least 3 months of snow here in Michigan, and you know, our winter sometimes lasts as long as 5 months, so we're really excited once we get that thawing temperature in February, March. We're excited for spring every year. Michiganders look forward to every season of the year. And just remember, your rabbits are built for wintertime. We're not built for wintertime, so that's why we struggle a little bit more than our rabbits do. As long as you're changing the water every 12 hours, your rabbits are gonna be just fine. You wanna fill it up again with lukewarm water. Remember that ice, when you see that little hole missing and they're chewing that away, that's good for their teeth. You know, I've spoken to several rabbitries in Alaska before, and they explain they put blocks of ice in their cages and they watch their rabbits gnaw it down. You know, the rabbits, they need to continue to chew, whether it's ice or wood or hay. This video helps, and I hope you keep your rabbits hydrated. Thanks for watching. And now we'll talk about what we do to get bigger litters and more does out of our litters. When it comes to your rabbitry, people come to buy a trio. It's gonna be two does and one buck, and those does go fast. Even if you had a nice litter of eight rabbits, four bucks and four does. Well, if you sell two trios, that's four does and two bucks. In many cases, we have a surplus of bucks, and sometimes those bucks go to the freezer. But how do you get more does? Well, the best thing that you can do, be sure to breed your does regularly. That keeps their bodies in check. You don't wanna overfeed your rabbit, because that'll cause breeding problems, that'll cause birth problems. You wanna make sure you keep your rabbits and your bucks healthy. The buck has to have good fertility as well. So make sure you're keeping your buck in the shade in the summertime. Even in the wintertime, when it gets about negative 10 or below, that can turn your buck sterile. So bucks need to be healthy as well. Your does, when you breed your does, be sure to rebreed 8 to 10 hours later. That is a big game changer. Rabbits, does are induced ovulators, so the act of breeding is what makes those eggs drop. So 8 to 10 hours later, those eggs will be ready for fertilization, and you wanna rebreed your doe. Now, some cases, the doe knows that she's already pregnant. She doesn't want anything to do with that buck, and in that case, remove your doe, because you don't want her to injure the buck and that buck to keep trying and aggravate her. But you need to at least try, because that is how you're going to get more does. Rebreeding will make for bigger litters. It will make sure that every embryo on both sides of the uterus horn are fertilized, and you want full conception the best you can. If you can get 8 to 10 kits, that's great. Any more than that, that is terrific. So that is how you get more does, by rebreeding. Also, keep your doe in the buck's cage for 30 minutes, regardless if you've already had a couple fall-offs. But you need to keep her in there for 30 minutes. She's less likely to go to the bathroom in his cage than she is in her own cage. You put her back in her own cage, she might go to the bathroom right away. So keep her in there. He's gonna breed her several times. And after 30 minutes, then remove her. 8 to 10 hours, go out there on a Saturday morning, 7 a.m., bright and early. I go back out there about 5 p.m. At the end of the day, I rebreed her. So that I do it on my day off. That way I can have the opportunity to be there to rebreed her. This will make for big litters. Now, of course, if your rabbit's getting older, then she may not be able to hit these numbers. It depends on how intense you breed them. They're gonna last different time periods based on the intensity of breeding. So this time of the year, entertain slowing your rabbitry down, maybe only because the temperatures are gonna be so cold here in about 30 days that when your doe kindles, it's really gonna be tough to keep those kits warm. Now the rabbits, as long as they stay clustered, will stay around 100 degrees. Their body heat keeps them warm. It's amazing how they can survive. But with the kindling box, kits can be pulled out of the kindling box, and you're gonna get frozen kits on the wire, and that's no fun. So I would just recommend that maybe slowing down till about February or March, when you have better temperatures and rabbits, longer days, and that's gonna make for better breeding. Christmas is right around the corner. If you have anybody that would love a rabbit sweater, we have these. This is our last year's sweater. We have tons of sections in our storefront. Gotta have it, gadgets, tools, men's health, tons of different things for gift ideas for your family and friends if you guys need to do any shopping. Thank you so much. You don't have to buy anything if you take a look, but thanks so much for taking a look. And anybody who buys anything is helping our channel. So if you like this content, it's an excellent way to help support this channel. And all the funds raised in that go right back into making videos. So thank you so much for helping our channel. Merry Christmas to you and your family, and we'll see you on the next video.